Oh, there it goes. Okay, here we have a test apparatus with a vacuum chamber here. And we've got a hand pump hooked up to that. Inside the chamber is a standard plasma globe, plasma ball. We'll zoom in. Okay, we've got the plasma ball inside of the vacuum container here, and we're taking the vacuum down. As you can see, our hose goes underneath, and here it is being pumped. Loyal helper here, loyal lab technician, and oh,
there it goes, not even 20,
just caught it. It's got a slight glow left, but it basically, the bulb is out at this point. It's completely out now, so we have a question whether the plasma ball is draining the batteries more than usual now, or less than usual, or maybe it's even charging the batteries. That would not be cool. Okay, further experiments with our plasma ball. They have a magnet on the top. It's a ring magnet with north-south orientated that way on the magnet instead of north-south this way. And so we're going to just set that on top very dangerously. And then we're going to put the vacuum chamber on top and take it down and see what happens. So far everything's about the same as when we began. How many inches of mercury do we have there?
19.
Last time we got an effect at 22, I think it was, where the entire plasma ball shut down. Oh!
20 now.
And it just did the same thing. Wow, look at that.
At 20, aye, I still...
So at 20, it cut out the plasma ball. We're still amazed by this phenomenon. Even when you touch close to it, doesn't
see, the middle is glowing now.
Oh yeah, it is glowing a little bit.
It's at 19.
Got the middle glowing slightly.
Did we kill it already?
It's starting to come 15. Back a little bit. 15, eh? Oh, there it's back. 13. Pretty much normal there now at how much?
13.
Let me take it back up to 15. You think it would cut out?
At 21.
21. Whoops, there it goes. It just disappeared. Isn't that something? At 21, that's about where it was before, and it just cut right out and stopped working. That is a very strange phenomenon. We have a dead plasma ball. Well, let's see if we can bring it back to life. There it goes. So we're at, what's that, 15? 15 this time instead of 13 last time. So it's around a 5 inches of mercury range where this plasma ball cuts out, and then it won't cut back in again until it drops down 5 inches of mercury. Inches of mercury now. Still have a pretty good arc, about like it was originally. The sand pumping is just not the way to go for efficiency. But boy, we're building up our forearms.
No,
22. Oh, wow. So it's staying at 20. Oh, just went out. Look at that. Just like a switch. Bingo, gone. My assistant is a little out of breath on this experiment. He's breathless. It is rather breathtaking, actually, to see this plasma globe just instantly go out. At how much? It was 22 inches of mercury. Oh, it just came back.
Really? It's still a 22.
Oh my god. That is so bizarre.
I guess that means more pumping.
It's your cue. I'm holding the camera. Oh, there it goes.
22 and a half now.
Yeah. We had a theory that it has to do with the capacitance of the air around the globe, that is the plasma globe, not the world globe, would tend to make the plasma work. So if we take away the air, the plasma no longer has a place to flow to. But then we put this tin foil in, touching the metal down below here, the metal fitting where the tin foil's connected. Nothing, nada. She's dead in the water.
Worst I can get, I'm afraid.
Well, it's not doing anything different. I don't think it will. It's just doesn't want to work.